In today's video, I'm going to talk about Ray Dalio's new obsession. As you might have guessed from my t-shirt, his new obsession is India. After the China debacle, in fact, Ray Dalio lost a lot of money investing in Chinese stocks and recently had to sell most of his positions, he recently tweeted about India very positively. Ray Dalio tweeted, "I am pleased to be able to help PM Modi, as he's a man whose time has come when India's time has also come. He and India are in an analogous position to Deng Xiaoping and China in the early 1980s, at the brink of the fastest growth rates and biggest transformation in the world. I believe that Modi has what it takes to have the greatest impact on the largest number of people in the world at a time that the risks of harmful impact are greater than at any time in our lifetimes." So Ray Dalio is comparing today's India to China of the 1980s. And as we all know, from the 1980s, its GDP grew enormously, and right now the projections for India growth are impressive. These are India's GDP growth projections taken from Statista. As you can see, from 2023 until 2028, analysts expect India's GDP to grow 6% per year, which is really a good number. Therefore, Ray Dalio could be right. It could be a good time to invest in India. And Bridgewater holds two ETFs which have exposure to Indian stocks. It owns the iShares Core MSCI Emerging Markets ETF, an ETF investing in emerging markets, and 15% of this ETF is invested in India. And Bridgewater also owns the Vanguard FTSE Emerging Markets ETF, which has an exposure of around 18% to India. India is for sure a very interesting country, and it is probably going to grow a lot in the next 5 and 10 years. But before investing in such countries, I strongly recommend to do a lot of research. These are not easy countries, and everything can go wrong, as we have seen with the Chinese stocks. Therefore, be very careful if you're going to invest in emerging markets. They are very risky places. I personally don't have a position in India right now. I never invested in an Indian stock, but we'll see. I can think about it. During the past 5 years, the Nifty 500, an index made of Indian stocks, had a very good performance, up 76%. Let me know what you think about India in the comments section, and please remember to leave a like and subscribe to my YouTube channel if you're new. See you next time. Bye!